Hey there, AppSec enthusiasts. I'm Louis, your guide in the world of application security. Today, we are diving into a topic that many of you have been asking about: how to get started with code review. So grab a cup of coffee, sit back, and let's dive into this fascinating subject. Just read code. How many times have you heard this advice for getting started with code review? Well, while it's a good start, we often miss an important details. What code should you begin with? Starting too hard can be discouraging, while starting too easy may not challenge you enough. Let's break down a path that you can follow to build your code review skills. The key is to begin with something manageable, like small snippets of vulnerable code. You may want to start with your favorite language or the one you are the most comfortable with. Platforms like PentesterLab offer a code review badge, providing small examples that are perfect for building your confidence. But what if you don't have access to those snippets? That brings us to step number two. You can look at patches and follow security mailing lists from open source software you are using. Some great places to start include the Apache Foundation mailing list and the Ruby on Rails security mailing list. This will provide you with a diversity of vulnerabilities and languages, and well-documented issues that make it easier to get started. If you have a few projects you use on a regular basis and like, look for CVEs in those. Once you feel confident with patches, why not take on libraries? These smaller code bases often focus on solving one problem, allowing you to compare multiple implementations and spot missing checks. It's like playing spot the difference. You find 3 checks in library A and 4 checks in library B. What is the security impact of the missing check in library B? Good first targets may include libraries for JWT, session management, or file processing. You will find great resources like jwt.io/libraries to help you on your journey. When performing those reviews, do not grab for bugs. Focus on understanding what the code does, how it does it, and if there are some security implications. You can use grep later or when you become more confident. But when you are learning, you should be reading code to understand it, not just looking for low-hanging fruits. If you only look for simple vulnerabilities and don't find them, you may get discouraged. And even if you find some low-hanging fruits using grep, you won't learn much. As you grow in confidence, classic software becomes your next frontier. But be cautious not to bite off more than you can chew. Start with common features like user registration, password reset, and file uploads before moving on to the entire code base. And don't rush into hard targets like WordPress, Kubernetes, or Apache HTTPD. Created lists like awesome and a language can guide you towards softer, less mature code bases to enhance your skills. Now, the most important part. How do you know you are succeeding? Don't measure progress by the vulnerabilities you find or don't find. Focus on your understanding, the complexity of patterns you know, and your ability to approach new code bases. Remember, quality over quantity is key, especially when studying. It's not about reading fast, it's about reading well. And that's your roadmap to becoming a skilled code reviewer. It's a journey of gradual progression, understanding, and quality focus. If you want to accelerate your study, be sure to check out PentesterLab Pro and our code review badge. If you enjoy this video, don't forget to share it with friends who may find it useful. Until next time, happy code review.